Good morning, students. In this video, we are going to learn nervous system and skeletal system. Nervous system and skeletal system. So, our body contains different types of organs, many types of organs. For vision, eyes. For smell and breathe, nose. For eating and tasting, mouth and tongue. For listening, ears. For walking, legs. Doing some work. For lifting something, hands. For digestion process, digestive system. Like that, nervous system is also there. This nervous system divided into two types. One is CNS and one is PNS. CNS means central nervous system. CNS means central nervous system. And PNS means peripheral nervous system. PNS means peripheral nervous system. Nervous system divided into two parts. One is central nervous system and second one is peripheral nervous system. So, the coordination of these two systems could make the human being body, not only human being body, a creature's movements or actions and reactions all over are completely maintained by this nervous system. Brain, spinal cord, these are under central nervous system, and remaining all the nerves which are connected to remaining all the parts of the body are coming under peripheral nervous system. Peripheral nervous system. Okay, namma? And functions of the brain. This function, this brain weighs nearly about 1.5 kg in a human being, and it contains nearly 100 billions of neurons. A brain contains nearly 100 billions of neurons. So what are neurons? They are very tiny brain cells which can carry the information from organs to nervous system and nervous system to organs. Those cells are called neurons. Neurons are very tiny cells which are connected one each other. And the neurons which could carry the information from all the organs to nervous system and central nervous system, from nervous system to all the organs. Okay, namma? This is functions of the brain. And functions of spinal cord. What are the functions of spinal cord? Spinal cord, and one more thing, again, this brain is divided into three parts. One is midbrain, forebrain, and brainstem. Otherwise, in other words, forebrain, this brain is divided into three parts. Forebrain, brainstem, and hindbrain. Forebrain, brainstem, and hindbrain. Okay, next, functions of spinal cord. What are the functions of spinal cord? Spinal cord is a white colored tube which could be passed from medulla oblongata, the third part of the brain, medulla oblongata. The spinal cord is connected to medulla oblongata, and from there onwards it extends to downwards. Okay, namma? This cord is the reason for a human being rigidity. Means if I stood like this, the reason of this is spinal cord only. If spinal cord is unable to do the work completely, thus that person has to be bedridden lifelong. Okay, so this spinal cord is responsible for mainly three actions. The spinal cord is responsible for mainly three actions. One is carrying information. Carrying information, coordination, and the third one is controlling reflexness. These are the three functions, main three functions of spinal cord. So what is carrying information? Because of this, from this nervous system, all the neurons are connected to all the remaining parts of the body. For example, carrying information, what is that? Let us see. For example, I kept my hand on a hot pan. What I will do then suddenly? Definitely I will remove my hand from there. Why? Because when I kept my hand on that hot pan, that heat, this the skin of my hand touches that heat and it feels that heat. Why? Because soon the message was sent to the central nervous system through the spinal cord. That's why I could remove my hand. So that is called carrying information. Next one is coordination. At the same time, I'm talking to you, I'm writing on the board, I'm observing you, I'm walking. So all the tasks could be done at a time. Meanwhile, I'm breathing also. So this is called coordination. And next one is controlling reflection. Controlling reflexness means just body is stable like this because of this spinal cord. This is called reflexness. Okay, ma? And next, skeletal system. What is skeletal system? Skeletal system is one of the most important systems in any creature, which is acts like a case, protective case for inner organs of the body. Okay, skeletal system acts like a case, protective case for inner organs of the body. And at initial stage, this skeletal system contains, when we are in infant stage means when we are below 9 years, like that, our bones will be 300 to 350 bones we may have. When we grown up more than 9 years of age, then these bones will totally comes to 206 bones by joining some small bones in some spaces. So that's a different topic, you could get that in further studies. Okay, ma? And next one is support. Because of this skeletal system only, this is the only support to us. These bones are support to us. That's why we are standing like this. And next one is protection. The skeletal system only can protect all inner organs of the body. For example, I fell down like this. Without skeletal system, what will be happen to my heart? What will be happen to my liver? liver. Heart is here and liver is here, sorry. Okay. What will be happen to my heart? What will be happen to my liver? And what will be happen to my eyes without skeletal system? So it can protect all the inner organs of the body. And movement, because of this skeletal system only we can stand like this. Because of this skeletal system only we can move like this. Otherwise, if there are no bones are nothing but skeletal system. If there are no bones, how could we make it? Just like a rigid emantaru chapati muddalaga pettukoni kucholala ante. Okay na? Next, storage. Our bones are a warehouse, like a storehouse of many cell organelles and minerals, blood and something. Everything will be stored inside the skeletal system only. Next, blood cell formation. Most of the blood cells will be formed inside the bone cells only. Inside the bones like its bones will be like a stick like structures, right? The inside those bones only more number of blood cells will be formed. Okay namma? So this is what about nervous system and skeletal system. By the next video we will finish this chapter and go for the notes. Okay amma, please go through the videos once again and make a short note by yourself. Thank you.